Hello everyone, welcome to another video of PLC programming using CODESYS. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can create a visualization in which the text which is shown in different parts could be shown in different language. As you can see here, I have a couple of text shown here in English, but I have these three other options as well. So if I click on German, everything is shown in German. If I click on Turkish, everything is shown in Turkish. And if I click on Kazakh, everything is displayed in Kazakh language. So if you follow this video, you will learn how to do this on your own. Alright, so let's get started. To begin, I have created an empty project. We can also have a look at this POUs tab here, and you can see that there is only the project settings for now. As the next step, I'm going to right click on the application and add a visualization to my project. We can have a second look at the POUs, and here you can see that now, in addition to the project settings that we had, we have the library manager and the global text list. The global text list is added automatically to our project, and initially it is empty. As soon as I add any item in the visualization, like a button, and start to provide text for it, let me call this as English. As soon as I introduce this text here, if you check the global text list, you can see that it is now added into our text list. There is an ID given to it that's automatically assigned, and then we have the value for it, the default value. I can duplicate this button and change the text inside. So instead of English, I'm going to have German, and one more time I'm going to use another language here. Let's use Turkish and Kazakh for now. Now if we check again our global text list, you can see that all those new texts are added automatically. The aim of this project is to be able to translate the text that we have in our project. For that, I'm going to right click here in the global text list and then choose add language. The language that I'm going to introduce are English, then German, then Turkish, and finally Kazakh or KZ. We can see that they are empty. The default values are the ones that I have in English, so I can write them here. And we need to fill all the other columns as well. I just filled the global text list, as you can see here, for different languages: English, German, Turkish, and Kazakh. Now, one thing that I can do here is that I click on each of these buttons, and then in the input configuration, on mouse click, I configure them to change the language. I add it here, and then for each one I need to choose a language. For English, I'm going to use EN and click on OK. For German, I will do the same, but this time I'll choose DE. For Deutsch, for Turkish, I will choose TR. And finally, for Kazakh, I'm going to choose KZ. Now we are in the run mode. If I click on English, you can see that nothing happens because the default language is English. If I click on German, the text is changed now. Clicking on Turkish changes as well. And also on clicking on Kazakh, you can see that the text is updated. Now I'm going to introduce some new text into the project, and then you will see how the language of the text will be updated automatically by clicking on any of these buttons. So here I have added this label with this text, the current status, and I also have added this text field for which I'm going to assign a text variable. If we check the global text list again, you can see that the current status is appearing here in the default column. The value for the other columns is empty, so we need to specify it. Instead of starting to type the value for each column here, for each new row or new text that we get, one way is to export this. You specify a file name and equation, and then click on export. Once exported, we will have a CSV file in the destination, as you can see here, and then we can update the values. It might be easier for you to deal with the text in the CSV file rather than directly in the visualization of the CODESYS. And once the file is updated, we can import it into the CODESYS environment. I've updated the CSV file and saved it. Now I can go back to the CODESYS, right click here in the global text list and choose import or export text list, and this time click on import. Now I need to select the file for the first field. Click on import here and click on OK, and you should see that the text here will be updated. For the text field here, I'm going to use a text list. Therefore, I'm going to add a new text list to my project. added to the project. And then I'm going to have two values for the ID 0 and 1 because I'm going to have two states for the text there. As for the status, I'm going to write working fine. And the second one is stop. This is the default language that I'm using and it is English. Here as well, similar to what we did in the global text list, I need to add the languages. English, German, and the others. And again, I need to translate these terms, working fine and stop, into these three additional languages. We can similarly export this text list as CSV file to a new file in it and then update it there as well. So both are the same. We can also edit the text list directly over here. As you can see here, I have updated my text list. Also in the visualization, I have inserted a switch. I have associated it with a new variable that I have declared in the PLC underline PRG as B status, a Boolean variable that you can see here. And also for my text field, I have determined the text list as the one that I have just created and have shown it to you. And also for the, as for the index, I've used the same Boolean variable. All right, so now let us see how it's going to work. All right, so right now you can see that everything is in English. If I click on German, all the text is now translated into German, or the German translation is used. If I click on this switch here, you can see the state is updated and the updated text is also shown. And the same thing happens if I click on the Turkish or Kazakh. In all four cases, we can switch the language without any problem. We just need to pay attention that we have the translation of all the text that we have in all the languages, in the global text list and also in the text list that we add manually to our project. All right, so that's it for this video. Thank you for watching and hope you have enjoyed this video. Please don't forget to like the video, comment your concerns under it, and also subscribe to my channel in order to support me. Bye for now.